Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this lecture we'll be seeing how a connection has been established in the 3GPP LTE environment. Here there are various steps and procedures involved for establishing a connection. Remember, the connection is established both the ways, that is from the mobile station to the base station and also from the base station towards the mobile station. In this lecture, we'll be studying how to establish a connection in an LTE. The very first thing that the mobile station will have to do is to acquire the timing of the signal in the cell. And this is done via SS, that is scanning and synchronization. Only after that, it can learn about the important cell information that has been transmitted on the broadcast channel. Broadcast channel is from the base station to the mobile station. Hence, all the mobile phones will receive this broadcast information. And then it will perform other functions that it needs to do for communication. After the mobile station has acquired the timing information and the reception of the BCH, the broadcast channel, additional cell information is communicated in the system information blocks. These blocks are transmitted via DLSCH and they are similar to the reception of the payload data. DLSCH stands for Downlink Shared Channel. There are a number of different SIB, that is system information blocks, been defined depending on the type of information they carry. The first system information block contains the information about the access to the cell. It also contains information about the cell selection. Access to the cell tells how the channels are available in that particular cell and the information about which of the cells are available. It also contains system indicators, window length. This system indicator window length is enabled for multiple transmission of SI messages, that is system information messages, within the window. This window length can be 1, 2, 5, 10, 15, 20 or 40 milliseconds. The SIB2 contains the information regarding the configuration that is valid for all the mobile station, like the configuration for common channels that are available, pilot channel configuration, timers, etc. The SIB from 3 to 8, they contain information related to the inter-system, inter-frequency and intra-frequency handovers. We have seen all these various handovers in the previous lectures. The SIB9 contains an identifiers for the home base station. SIB10 and 11 contain the information for earthquakes or tsunami warnings. Specifically, they have been allotted for emergency services. The LTE specifies a procedure for random access in 4 steps. The very first step is the mobile station transmits an random access preamble which allows the base station to compute the required timing advances. If the mobile station wants to join the network, it has to let the base station first know about this request. The mobile station does not have any resources by this time assigned to it, therefore it must make a connection based access, that is a random access. It is possible that this request will collide with the request from the other mobile stations. The LTE specifies the procedure for this access proceedings in 4 steps. The first step is the mobile station transmits a random access preamble which allows the base station to compute the required timing advances. In the second step, the base station transmits an RA response. RA is nothing but the random access response for the mobile station to which the preamble was transmitted. It contains the index of the random access preamble for which the response is valid. It also sends the timing advances that is to be used by the mobile station. The resources to be used by the mobile station for signaling in the subsequent steps. It sends a temporary ID. Note if there are several mobile stones that have used the same RA preamble, then the RA response message is valid for all the mobile stations. And this results in a collision. This collision will be resolved in the subsequent steps. In the third step, the mobile transmits the radio resource control signaling information, which contains the ID. The details of this information basically depends on how much information the base station is already having about the mobile station. For example, whether the mobile station is accessing the network for the very first time or it is just re-establishing a connection after the connection has been interrupted. So if it is a fresh connection for the first time, then all the information is required. If it is a re-established connection, then less amount of information is required. This contention resolution message is basically a message that has been sent for the disagreement resolution. This disagreement is regarding which mobile is trying to access. Ambiguities could have occurred if multiple mobiles are trying to access the system with the same random access preamble. In this resolution message, the base station transmits explicitly or exclusively the ID of the mobile station to which it assigns the resources. The second type of connection is a connection using paging. For paging, each mobile station is assigned a paging interval and a certain subframe in which the paging message will be transmitted. Thus, the mobile station needs to wake up from the sleep state once per paging interval and listen to whether the data is available or not. The paging interval can be configured, representing a trade-off between the energy saving and the delay in the message. So this is how a connection is established in LTE. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to eKida and subscribe to eKida.